169, and it's a sad day today. The Anchor Steam Beer Company from San Francisco, been in business for, 123 years, just went out of business. This was the first beer that I really learned to enjoy and drink, and now this is it. So we have the Come and Go Casamigos tequila shot and the steam beer, and I'm gonna pour it into this frozen glass. There's the steam. Oh my lord, look at that. They called it steam back then, probably because of the early brewing methods. And when they would open, you know, the sealed vats or kegs or whatever, all the steam would come out. And I don't even think they had refrigeration methods back when they first started with this. They probably did it with ice. So anyway, clink. Oh, jeez, look at this. Move your hand, Doc Love. Lip. Separate my lip. Show 169. How appropriate. A great number for a sad day. So, Anchor Steam is dead. Long live Anchor Steam. And long live Coronasphere. All right.
I think I got a long way to go.
No, 118,
man, that's a lot of shows. I think we should celebrate. Lift, clink, celebrate
my lips. Oh. Celebrate your lips.
You know, Oh, that's good. That's like a blood orange kind of thing.
It is.
From San Francisco?
That would be the one.
Yep. You know, we've done all, you know, the clink and lift. It's all great and everything, but I just feel sometimes we need like...
A cigar, something.
You know, like to say, you know, but we don't have any cigars, do we?
A celebratory puff smoke, if you will.
Well, I do. I got a match box. We could do that. What do you think about it?
Cheeky, clever man.
Well, I'm sitting here watching Matchbox holding my clothes. And I'm sitting here wondering if a Matchbox will hold my clothes. I ain't got no matches, but I sure got a long way to go. I'm an old poor boy and I'm a long way from home. I'm a long poor boy and I'm a long way from home. I never been happy cause everything I ever did was wrong. Well, if you don't want my peaches, honey, please. Carl Perkins to get the show going, huh?
And what's that got to do with 18?
Nothing.
Okay.
I like opening with some rock and roll. Man, why are you pushing on me to try to?
I'm just asking.
You're pushing too hard. No, you're just
effectively.
Like,
I just thought.
You know, effectively, effectively stepping on his blue suede shoes.
You're pushing too hard. You're pushing on me. You're pushing too hard. What you want me to be? You're pushing too hard about the things I say. You're pushing too hard every night and day. 'Cause you're pushing too hard. You're pushing too hard on me.
Too hard.
Well, all I want is to just be free. Live my life the way I want to be. All I want is just to have the fun. Live my life like it's just begun. But you're pushing too hard. You're pushing too hard on me.
Too hard.
Yeah. Kazuna. I don't know what else to do now. Yeah. Better listen, girl, what I'm telling you. You better listen, girl, or we are through. You better stop all your fooling around. Stop all your running all over town. 'Cause you're pushing too hard. You're pushing too hard on me.
Too hard.
Well, I know there's a lot of fish in the sea. I know some would have stayed by me. So if you think I'm too hard on me,
too hard.
Well, you're pushing too hard, you're pushing too hard, you're pushing too hard, you're pushing too hard on me,
too hard.
Yeah, you're pushing too hard, you're pushing too hard, you're pushing too hard, you're pushing too hard.
An ending.
I thought you were gonna keep going.
No. Oh, we dedicate that to Mr. Terry Taylor, who built his entire vocal style on groups like this. This was by the Seeds, one of my favorite garage punk bands from the 60s. And I found this little segment on YouTube. I didn't realize that they were hired to do a guest spot on the show called The Mothers-in-Law. It was a Desi Arnaz production with Eve Arden and they put him in a living room with all these straight people, right? And they're all dressed in, you know, hippie beads and everything. And the whole band's in there. And the thing is, if you listen to it, they played live to their own record. So the drummer's literally playing on set. They have the live mics and everything. And you can hear him playing, and they're, like, nailing it. It's like that's where usually, you know, they just fake it. But it's like those guys were actually playing it in that living room, and it was just like, man, they never missed a beat. It was really good.
I blew the reed out of one of these kazoos, so I had to switch midstream.
That's okay. This is that kind of show. Mr. Chris Harrelson, ladies and gentlemen, on kazoo.
Well, hello, dear.
You blew the kazoo. Literally.
Yep.
Oh. We're going to do a Ryan Adams song.
I like that?
Yeah, that's nice. This is from the Kerosene Halo Live Simple album.
Ah, the night here comes again. It's on with the jeans, the jacket, and the shirt. How'd I end up feeling so bad for such a little girl? And I hold you close in the back of my mind. Feels so good, but damn, it makes me hurt. scared to know how I feel about you now. La Cienega just smile, see you around.
Nice, Mike.
Yeah, I love.
He's a great songwriter.
He's a great songwriter, and I love the way that that guitar looks on camera.
Nice.
That's just my favorite thing in the world, anyway.
Well, you love this guitar.
I do.
It's an expensive object.
I'm glad that you do.
What's not to love?
Hey, man, you back to this song, though. You recorded a wonderful vocal on this.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's really great. It may be. I mean, I've listened to a lot of your stuff. I think it may be the best vocal that you've recorded.
Bruce is saying that because I told him that earlier. Well, here's the thing. I'm the most critical of my vocals more than anyone on the planet. I'm sure you are, too, of your own.
Oh, I was going to say of yours, yes.
Oh, yeah, you're very critical of my vocals. And then I was in the shadow of trying to do a Ryan Adams cover, who's known for, you know, his singing. But in that case, you know, I got it because it was in my range. It was good. And then I went back and listened to him, and I went, well, I cut him. I cut Ryan. I think I did. Anyway, enough of that.
So now, okay, so when are we doing an 18 song for this?
We should do one right now. Now, this... I remember...
118,
yeah,
by the
118.
Way. Let's pause for a moment to Observe the gravity of 118 shows. You know what I mean? We just keep making them, and it's 118 shows. That's pretty impressive, man. 118.
It is.
We're way beyond 2 years now. So we just want to thank everybody that's stuck with us and continues to make this show a part of their regular routine at some point.
Your regular 18.
And it keeps entertaining them, you know what I mean? Because gosh knows how that happens. But here's to you guys. Okay, what do you got, buddy?
Well, this is a tune that I remember as a kid vaguely. I mean, I was about 9 when it was a hit, and I thought that Wayne Newton had recorded this. And it turns out it was Bobby Darin. Bobby Darin had the hit with this song, and then Marty Robbins recorded it and had a hit with it. And it's an interesting little tune. Listen to the lyrics carefully, and we're gonna try and pull this one off. I don't know it that well, but it's not that hard to do. What do you think?
Sure.
18 yellow roses came today. 18 yellow roses in a pretty bouquet. When the boy came to the door, I didn't know what to say. 18 yellow roses came today. I opened up the card to see what it said. I couldn't believe my eyes.
That's one of the best fake-out songs I've ever heard. Because up until the very last moment of it, I'm thinking that this guy's being jilted by his wife when the lover has the nerve to send. Now, did you get it right away, or did you think the same thing? Did you fall for it, too?
I was just actually looking at the chords. Why would you? I wasn't really paying attention to the lyric that much on this one.
Yeah, I didn't intend to play it like a...
Okay, let's read it. Let's see. What does it say?
Well, it's 18 yellow roses. Now, that should be a giveaway that it's a birthday, 18 years.
Okay, right.
His daughter is, you know, just turned 18.
Mm-hmm.
But
when
the boy came to the door, he didn't, you know, he just leaves it like he's nervous. He didn't know what to say, and then he opens the card. Now, why would this guy open the card? Because he didn't order the flowers, right? So it fakes you out, makes you think, well, who would send this to my wife, right? I couldn't believe my eyes that you belong to another,
I never doubted
your love. I always thought you'd be true, but now this, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And all I can do is ask the boy that's done this thing, and that's a little giveaway because it's boy, not the man.
And find out
he's going to buy you a ring. Well, that's a little, still, it's like, I still didn't get it
so
until.
So father's love.
Right, yeah.
It was his daughter.
Right. I know, the whole thing. So it only works like the first time you hear the song, if you get it, if you even pay attention. Gee. I think most people that heard this song didn't even...
They just thought it was another...
Oh, yeah, yeah, another children, yeah. Sort of thing. It's like, I went, wow, man. I don't know, maybe I'm just an idiot, but...
yeah, I think it's...
I like it. And, you know, I never intended to play it with a country beat. I think that...
oh, that's not it?
No, it's like eight.
Oh, wow.
Cantina.
Oh, wow, okay. What in the world are we doing then?
Hidden yellow roses came today. It makes a nice country tune.
I think it does.
Yeah.
In fact, I think it's really good in your hands.
Okay.
With your voice. speaking about a song in the hands of the singer, you know what I mean, or within the grasp of a talent that will turn it into
something other
yeah,
than
bring it to life,
bring it
right
to another
before
place.
Your eyes.
We're going to feature none other than Mr. Christian Harrelson, who
Christian
been,
Cooper Harrelson.
Well, we've been, is that his middle name?
It no. is today.
Is it today?
No, it begins with a T.
Okay, that's right. That's even on his face frack. We've been neglecting Chris's vocalizing for a while, except for when he jumps in on the harmonies. And I wanted to sing this because I've been compared to this idiot for the last 40, 50 years.
Without the eyeliner and makeup.
Right, yeah, none other than Mr. Alice Cooper. Now that my hair isn't long anymore, I don't get that as much. But I got it for a long time.
Never occurred to me.
Oh, man. Go look at the pictures of me with long hair and look at he and I were twin sons. But anyway, a lot of people don't remember or don't know that, you know, it was Frank Zappa that discovered and signed Alice Cooper's and the band to his label.
Oh, I didn't know that. Barking Pumpkin?
No, well, no, before that it was called Straight Records. It was an imprint of Warner's, and they gave Frank his whole label for a while, and he put Uncle Meat and a bunch of stuff on that label. And he went and signed the GTOs, the all-girl group. That was the first. And Alice Cooper didn't have any hits with Alice. But eventually, I think Warner's bought him out of the contract, put some more money into it, said, we're going to get behind these guys. And this song, I heard this song when around the age of, you know, 18 or so. And I went, oh, my gosh, this is my life, you know. It's like I realized this guy is more than just this weird guy. It's like this song really got under my skin.
Yeah.
So, but it's a bit hard to sing, and I think Mr. Harrelson has the gravel and the grits to do it.
This track is like, I don't know, I mean, it reminds me kind of an English track, like the Trogs, or, you know, it's like
it's got a bit of that.
It's that kind of thing.
But I love the lead guitars. I love it. I just think it's a rock classic. It's like I dig rock and roll. It's like one of those.
All right, so tune in. Christian Harrelson from the command deck.
Oh, dear.
Bring it on home, boy.
Here we go.
One, two, three.
And hands, lines form from the
Yeah. Well. Yeah.
Oh, man. Wow. What can be said that hasn't already been said?
That's
that
a wild man.
That was insanity. I'm really glad you did that, Chris. I couldn't have, I would have blown out my pectoral muscles.
Well, I'm working on this hernia here. So,
I know we put you at risk with that. Thank you for.
I agreed to do it.
Thank you for your daring and your courage.
Look, and what all I'm saying is this might be the appropriate time.
Oh, really? Well, look, might as well.
I'm gonna have to have surgery here soon, so.
Oh, let's get it done. Okay. All right. Well, then I'm gonna put back on my shades, and I'm gonna go that. Thank you, everybody, for your continued generosity in helping us. I'm just blessed and dead chuffed, man. Chuffed, is it chuffed? With you guys hanging in with us. If you want to contribute to us this week and you use PayPal, it's paypal.me/micro77s. The Venmo people, it's at micro77s. And, you know, I haven't checked my P.O. box. I need to get out there, man. There may be a big gonzo check waiting for us. Who knows? So if you want to write one of those gonzos, just write 77S LTD on the check, on the envelope, underneath write P.O. box 1441, Citrus.
Orange, you glad June is over?
Heights?
A little bit lofty there.
California, 95611. And thank you, Mr. Harrelson. I think you were inspired by your vote. We need to let him sing more because it makes him do better on the tip thing.
Well, hopefully
everybody else does.
Yeah, hopefully the fans.
Everyone needs to send in a big tip.
We'll vote for that
since we had
or vote against it. Your vote counts either way.
Well, we'll do like the Andy Kaufman thing on SNL where they took a vote. Do you want everyone that wants Andy to come back vote yes, and if you don't want to see him again, vote no. There were so many no's. He never was on it again.
Wow.
No, it was serious.
On what show?
Saturday Night Live. Oh, wow. Yeah, because he
was. And then the whole Fridays deal was bad, too.
Was he on there?
Michael Richards wouldn't even be in the biopic.
Because of what?
Because of the thing that happened on that episode of Fridays.
Oh, well, we'll have to talk about that. What did happen? I mean, you might as well just tell us.
They had a fight. On,
oh, there was nobody, a fist fight?
And you're watching it live. On a Friday night, and you don't know whether this is real or what this is.
Oh, because he went off script.
He went nuts.
I think that's in the movie with the...
Yeah, but somebody else had... Michael Richards did not even make a cameo in that movie because of him.
Really? Yeah. Oh, he was still mad?
Yeah.
You know, I talked to...
And passions obviously still boil over.
Well, you know,
that.
He was still alive
when... Vicarious.
When 77 did our first album... Ping Pong Over the Abyss, we were working with Stephen Soles and Larry Hirsch, these Hollywood guys, right? So they knew everyone in Hollywood and everyone's business. And I brought up the fact that Andy Kaufman, I liked him and everything, and all of a sudden I watched them kind of bristle. And I go, what's the deal? And, you know, they're just shaking their heads going, man, everyone hates him.
He's bringing us all down.
Yeah, no, he did not, he was not... He wasn't well liked in the town.
Well, he was trolling the industry.
Yeah, I mean, light years ahead of his time. And oh my gosh,
Now, why in the world are we talking about him?
Because we got in that from when I said SNL, because you said something about voting whether Chris should sing more or whether he should.
Okay, so the voting thing. Yeah, the got voting to the Andy Kaufman thing, and then Andy in the industry,
jumped to
77's first album.
Nicely
done.
Yes, isn't that looped it back around. To and we bring it right away.
He got it right back to our topic.
We need to start doing the back to gag where we do that whole thing where you
get
keep
back
going.
To
yeah,
it.
You get all the way back. So
okay, so what's this?
There's a song that Mississippi John Hurt. He wrote this song based on the tales of a murder that happened back in the 1920s. I've heard Jerry Garcia do this with David Grisman and Tony Rice. I just really like this song. It's called Lewis Collins.
Beautiful chord right there.
Mrs. Collins, we, Mrs. Collins, more. What made her son, Lewis,
home. Angels laid him away. Angels laid him away. Laid him 6 feet under the clay. Angels laid him away. Oh, kind friends, now ain't it hard to see poor Lewis in a new graveyard? Angels laid him away. Angels laid him away. Laid him 6 feet under the clay. Angels laid him away. Bob shot one and Lewis shot two. Shot poor Collins, shot him through and through. Angels laid him away. Angels laid him away. Laid him 6 feet.
It's always so restful and enjoyable to listen to you play like that, dude.
I love just doing that stuff. Well, I like listening to that.
And what is that? What style is that picking? Just picking?
I would just call it, well, that's that Travis
picking.
Picking, that's right. That's I didn't play the melody, but I supported the melody. Now, if I wanted to have done it in a true Travis style, it was like a... It's a wonderful thing.
Yeah,
I'm just glad I learned it when I was a kid.
Great talent, son.
Because if I learned it, tried to learn it now, it'd be a lot harder.
That's great. I can listen to that all day.
Oh, it's great. Well, there's nothing like a lazy Saturday afternoon. If you have any patience or love for Jerry Garcia's voice and lazy style with David Grisman, who plays the most amazing mandolin, they did a series of albums together, and it's just that back, you know, front porch singing, you know, country folk bluegrass tunes like that, old, really old songs that have these great stories. I mean, that's where Jerry's heart was at. He was a folk guy.
Almost like singing around a fire pit.
Exactly. We got to do a show like that soon.
Yeah, soon.
Where we just have it all be in that place. Just
right at the campfire.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Well, Well, you know, I was going to do a Jerry tune for the hymn show, but I'm gonna save that because, you know, we got to stay in that. We keep talking about the Kinks. We love the Kinks.
We love the Kinks.
And so, because we love the Kinks.
Because we love the Kinks.
We're going to pick up the pace just a little bit right now and do a tune that we've done on the show before. We haven't done it for a long time for the hymn show, right? Called God's Children.
God made buildings that reach for the sky. Man made the motor car and learned how to drive. But he didn't make the flowers and he didn't make the trees. And he didn't make you and he didn't make me. And he's got no right to turn us into machines. The loser and the winner. We are all the same to him. Stripped of our clothes and all the things we own. Oh, the day that we are born, we are all God's children, and they got changes. We gotta go back to the way the good Lord made. Oh, the good Lord made us all, and we are all God's children, and they got no right to change us.
You slayed that.
Okay.
You
know,
I did. I forgot that was the one that we said that you, that was the other one you ripped off Lust intro from.
I just played that chord sequence. I don't even think that's on the record. I just did it because I like it.
Oh, you're
well, you notice how when someone
you're tagging it with your own thing,
well,
which was actually ripped from somebody else, but it is like, really
hey,
cool.
Hey, look, when guitar players, have you noticed what Chris, back me up in this. Guitar player picks up a guitar and he plays the D chord. He always goes, you know what I mean? It's like, it's just textbook. It's just like you doing a roll or something.
Gotcha.
Okay. By the way, thank you for that fill at the end. I love those daga 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 fills. I'm really glad you like those.
Well,
I don't have to beg you to do them.
I wanted to make a statement with backgrounds on this, but I just couldn't.
Were fine.
I couldn't remember.
Oh, come on.
I
dismembered.
I'm hoping it all gets ducked by the audio.
Oh boy.
Guy.
Whoever
it's
he
a
might
mess.
Be.
Where that guy has been absent a lot.
I
don't know.
I was a mess on that. I was a hot mess.
I thought it was great. You guys are great.
You guys are great. Well, okay, so.
Well, we're coming to the end of this.
Speaking about a great man.
Gosh, you know, the show has gone really quickly. You know, I don't know.
I mean, this one right here reminds me of, like, you know, like what we're talking about. It's like, you know, you might have expectations that, you know, by 118 shows, we've got it together. But the thing that happens is that we just don't work on the same show and get it perfected.
It's like on tour,
we're always starting over here.
Well, on tour you rehearse and then you play about 8 shows and then you've got it, right? And you might throw in a road apple here and there, but this is like every show they're all road apples every time.
Every show's a rewrite.
I'm telling you, remember the Dean Martin? we do the Dean Martin principle. He does everything once.
It's great.
No rehearsal.
So this one is kind of an anthem for exactly if you had high expectations.
Yes.
And you watch this now and then and
oh no, this should be our theme song. Yeah, but I mean, this song has already been appropriated by another famous person.
Oh really?
Not that we're famous, but
by another?
By another famous
an
person. An infamous person.
By a famous person.
Let's just say it's a person that is known. And so we're not doing this for that person or any other. We're doing this for you people, you persons.
You people.
And I want to just say that
you people.
How could it be that we've done... Oh, by the way, I just had the new database sent to me of our tunes, and we're already over 900
distinct. 900 tunes. 900 distinct tunes.
So we'll be publishing...
Tell your friends.
Yeah, tell your friends that...
We're going for the world record. Yeah. I think we should be checking on...
900 stink tunes?
We should be actually looking into what the world record is for consecutive weeks of shows.
Well...
A show.
There's a lot of people doing that, but I don't think there's...
Really?
I can't say that there's
That's
anyone...
That's a lot of shows, man.
Maybe not this kind of a thing.
Without though. A hiatus?
Well... There's something we're doing unique. Is it the non-rehearsal of complicated songs?
Yeah. The what?
Are you saying we hold the record for doing the most consecutive set of unrehearsed complicated songs?
Well, for the most stubborn production.
Yeah, there you go. All right.
The most determined production.
Well, all that to say that after 900 songs and 118 shows, we've yet to do this, one of the most obvious. I've been playing this since high school.
We've never done this?
No, we've never done it.
Oh, my gosh.
I'll take the first verse and you can jump in at that. I saw her today at the reception.
perception. In a glass was a bleeding man. She was practiced at the art of deception. Well, I could tell by her blood-stained hand.
Everybody, yeah. Sing with us. Come on.
And now you can't always get what you want.
Roll, please.